In this tutorial, we will create a bouncy text in DaVinci Resolve. Let's get to it. Here we are in DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to begin by opening Fusion page, then click on the text plus icon, and now I'll add two notes. Let's select the text one note. Make sure you have Inspector panel enabled. Then inside of the text box, you can type whatever you want. I'll do bounce. Then I'm going to change the font to Montserrat and make the text a bit bigger. So here we have it. After that, let's right click inside of the text box and select follower. That'll add an option of modifiers, click on that. Then while inside of the timing tab, we want to set delay to 2 seconds. Then go into shading settings. And here we want to move to frame 15 on a timeline. Then create a keyframe for opacity by clicking on this diamond icon. Then scroll down and open position settings. And we need the offset X and Y, create a keyframe on that. And as you do, you'll be moved to path 1 settings. And don't get confused, simply double click on the follower 1 to go back to those settings. Then we want to move to the start of the timeline to frame 0. And let's adjust the position first. So let's decrease the Y offset to negative 0.35 should be fine to move the text down. And then set opacity all the way to 0 as well. And this will give us a simple text reveal. And to create a bounce effect, we want to use spline. So click on spline. Then here check displacement. That's the only one we need. Then click zoom to fit to see the keyframes. And here we want to create another keyframe 10 frames after the second one. So this one is at frame 15. So we need to create another one at frame 25. And if we hover the cursor over the line, we get this plus icon. If we left click, we can create another keyframe at the same value. Let's click zoom to fit once again, then left click inside of the empty space, Control A to select all keyframes and press S on the keyboard to add easing to them. And here we want to focus on the middle keyframe. You can see how the graph goes up, up, and then it flattens down. And we want to create exact opposite of that. We need to reverse these handles. If we drag the left handle of the middle keyframe, up like that, you can see we reverse the whole graph. And if we leave it as it is and preview it, we'll get a very slight bounce at the end. And to exaggerate the bounce effect, we can extend these handles outward. So if I drag this all the way up to 1.6, somewhere in like 7.5 range, and then I drag this one down slightly as well. And also for the first keyframe, this one, drag it to the top right direction like that. So the whole animation looks faster at the start. And if we click zoom to fit now, this is how the graph should look. And if you preview this from the beginning, the bounce should be a lot more pronounced. And if for some reason the text becomes jumpy, you can fix that by scrolling all the way up and going to timing settings and just change the delay for something else. Let's say put 3 and then go back to 2 or whatever it was before. And that should fix the jumpy text. And I'm actually going to set delay to 3 seconds to increase the delay between each character. And if we preview this now, we should have this smooth, nice bounce effect on the text. So that is it for this one. Thank you guys for watching.